Good afternoon. I'll be talking about viral ouch. So presenting Mrs. P, she is a 42-year-old lady who's a housekeeping staff in a government primary health center in Gudiyatham, presented with low-grade fever, intermittent, which was along with non-bilious and non-projectile vomiting for past 5 days. At the time of admission, she was afebrile. The last spike was 2 days ago, followed by abdominal pain, which was dull, aching, epigastric pain for 2 days, with yellowish discoloration of sclera and high-colored urine, and generalized myalgia. She has a past history. She is a known case of diabetes mellitus for 2 years on oral anti-diabetic drugs. Personal history with no history of any previous blood transfusions or high-risk sexual behavior or history of any substance abuse. Treatment history, she has taken one dose of hepatitis B vaccination at her workplace, even though she was said that she was supposed to take 3 doses at the work. Occupational history, she is involved in segregation of hospital waste with a history of recent needle stick injury 2 weeks ago while handling those wastes. On examination, her sensorium was normal, vitals were stable, she was afebrile, she had pallor and icterus and bilateral pedal edema. On systemic examination, she had a tender liver, which was enlarged, palpable 3 cm below the costal margin, with a liver span of 16 cm. Other systemic examinations were normal. The clinical diagnosis that we came up to was the acute viral hepatitis, either A, E or B. The rationale behind this was she presented with prodromal symptoms. She had icterus, low-grade fever and tender hepatomegaly. The further differential diagnosis which were considered was malaria, scrub typhus, leptospirosis, enteric fever and spotted fever. So on initial investigations, the liver function tests were deranged, which was consistent with our clinical diagnosis of viral hepatitis. On further evaluation, HAV was negative, HEV was negative, though HBsAg was positive, and the other differentials which we were thinking, that was all negative. So the diagnosis which we thought was hepatitis B infection. But whether it was acute or chronic, that we were yet to find. So the trend in the hospital was she got admitted on 19th of October until 24th she was admitted, and the last 1st November was the follow-up date. So the total bilirubin, direct bilirubin, SGOT, SGPT and ALP was initially in an increasing trend, further reduced to the normal levels. So the differentiating feature between acute and chronic hepatitis B, if it's an depending upon the antigen and antibody patterns associated with the different clinical scenarios. Acute infection will have positive HBsAg and anti-HBc IgM. If it's a chronic infection, only HBsAg will be positive with anti-HBc of total. In our case, we had e-antigen, though positive. Quantitative PCR for HBV was 50,000 and IgM core antigen was positive. The cutoff value is 1.1. That's when it's called positive, and HBsAg is positive. So the final diagnosis was acute hepatitis B infection, probably secondary to the recent needle stick injury. Since there was no history of any previous transfusions, and the husband was tested and he was negative for the same. So in this presentation, we want to discuss about the problem of hepatitis B among the healthcare workers in India and the policies for prevention, the post-exposure prophylaxis and the treatment of hepatitis B. This is a cross-sectional study conducted in December 2014 to January 2015 in Ethiopia with 3 government hospitals. And the conclusion that was made was waste handlers will have increased exposure to hepatitis B infection. The anti-HBC, which had a p-value of 0.01, was significant. The prevalence in India of hepatitis B among healthcare workers, they are 4 times more exposed than the general population. In 1992, there was a study done which says 10% were exposed to the hepatitis B virus. In 1998, it was 2.21%. And in Delhi, 1% were, in the Delhi hospital, one study was done. It says positive for HBsAg positive was 1%. 55.4 healthcare workers were vaccinated, even though the number of doses were not described. And in CMC, the hepatitis B vaccination became mandatory in 1994. 30% of the staff, they had anti-HBC positive even before they got the pre-mandatory vaccination. This is the government of India, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. They have taken a decision to vaccinate all the healthcare workers who are at an increased risk of acquiring hepatitis B infection. People like conducting deliveries, giving injections, exposed to blood or blood products. So the post-exposure prophylaxis for exposure to HBV. If the exposed person is unvaccinated, so we give them one dose of hepatitis B immunoglobulin and initiate hepatitis B vaccine series, that is 0, 1, 6 months. And if the person is previously vaccinated, antibody response is unknown, we test the exposed person for anti-HBs. If it's adequate, there's no further treatment required. If it's inadequate, single dose of HBIAG and vaccine booster. For the management of acute hepatitis B infection, there's no specific therapy. Only the it's mostly by supportive treatment. Initial therapy is bed rest. Nausea and vomiting can be controlled by antiemetics, dehydration by IV fluids, and patient should probably not work during acute phase of the illness. So the next question that comes is, antiviral drugs, interferons, is there any role in acute hepatitis B? So this is a systemic review done by Cochrane Library on pharmacological interventions for acute hepatitis B infection, published in 2017. So which included 7 randomized controlled trials involving 2,230 patients. What they concluded was low and very low quality evidence suggests progression to chronic HBV infection was higher in people receiving the lamivudin compared to placebo, no intervention or entacavir. Interferon may increase the adverse events after treatment for acute HBV infection. So the conclusion is that currently there is no evidence of benefit of any intervention in acute HBV infection and recommend further randomized controlled trials. So the take-home message would be our case mostly highlights that the hepatitis B transmission continues to occur in the healthcare system and particularly the cleaning staff is more vulnerable. So the recommendations would be strict policies for protection of healthcare workers against the hepatitis B, particularly for the cleaning staff. Education about how hepatitis B is dangerous and how they can get transmitted through blood and blood products, and about the mandatory hepatitis B immunization. Our patient, she did not know that one person can get hepatitis B infection through a needle stick injury, and she did not know that even though she was told to have recommended dose was 3 doses, she said she took only 1 dose. She did not realize the importance of completing the full course of the vaccination. And personal protective equipment, because when we asked her, she said while collecting those bags from the hospital wards and keeping it in a place where they segregate it, she got a prick, needle stick injury. So it's better to use personal protective equipment while handling all these waste. Access to PEP. She had no idea, she did not have any access to prophylaxis. So she, after even she got the needle stick injury, she did not go to a hospital or get it checked. And the last thing, proper waste disposal, she would not have got the infection in the first place if we disposed the waste properly and in the right bags and right place. Thank you.
It was a good presentation, Eva. Any questions?
No. She's working in a PHC in Gudiyatam. Would want them to continue the full course of the vaccination. I didn't get it. Sorry. If she was working here, I would suggest she takes full 3 vaccination course, and then if while working she would better take care of the waste, like better take care how she is handling those wastes. And is that
you actually screen them for whether they've developed immunity, so you do anti-HBs. If it's less than 10, you give them a booster dose. And just an information, in places where, like India, where the vaccination is not complete, the incidence of hepatitis B is actually 5 to 10 times that of the general population.
Thank you.
Any other questions or comments? We'll move on to the next case where medicine 5, atypical invasion.
So I come from the era where I trained before hepatitis B vaccination was available. So I got hepatitis B when I was doing my bond in PMR. So I think the data that she highlighted that where before the mandatory vaccination, 30% of our staff actually had antibodies to hepatitis B. And all this emphasizes the importance of ensuring